Explore Pawan Kalyan's disclosure of his family's staggering 164.53 crore rupees wealth. Juxtaposed with his modest income, delve into his electoral affidavit, revealing assets, liabilities, and candidature details for the Andhra Pradesh Pitapuram Assembly segment. Uncover the controversies surrounding Kalyan, including criminal convictions and his party's role in the upcoming elections. Gain insights into the seat-sharing dynamics among NDA partners and Janasena's strategic positions. Witness the actor-politician's opulent vehicle collection amid electoral fervor. Today's next news is: the Directorate General of Shipping has issued an urgent advisory for Indian recruiting agencies and seafarers amidst the tensions in Iran and Israel. This advisory emphasizes the paramount importance of safety and urges caution in deploying seafarers to these regions, with potential security risks in mind. The advisory stresses the need for seafarers to register with Indian embassies for immediate assistance in case of emergencies. Today's next news is: learn about India's latest developments in defense acquisition, including the revised timeline for receiving the remaining S-400 Triumph missile systems from Russia due to delays caused by the conflict in Ukraine. Additionally, discover insights into the delivery schedule for Russian-built frigates, with the first warship expected in September and the second in January. Delve into the implications of these updates on India's defense capabilities and strategic partnerships. Today's next news is: in 2023, India ranked fourth globally in military spending, reaching $83.6 billion. According to a report by SIPRI, this marked a 4.2% increase from 2022 and a staggering 44% rise from 2014. The surge was primarily attributed to rising personnel and operations costs, emphasizing the nation's commitment to bolstering armed forces amid regional tensions. Notably, a significant portion of the budget was allocated to domestic procurement, showcasing India's push towards self-reliance in arms development. Today's next news is: discover the robust performance of Tata Consumer Products Limited India Foods business, which surged by 20% in the last quarter of financial year 2024. Dive into the details of Tata Consumer Products Limited's remarkable journey, witnessing a 4% volume growth and a notable 50 bits per second increase in salt market share. Explore the significance of like-for-like revenue growth, experiencing an impressive 11% surge. Uncover the e-commerce boom with a staggering 70% YoY growth. Join us as we analyze Tata Consumer Products Limited's strategic focus on premiumization and its impact on salt revenue, which soared by 5% in the quarter, marking a remarkable 9% increase throughout financial year 2024. Today's next news is: the Calcutta High Court, in response to violence during Ram Navami in Murshidabad, has requested a report from the state government and proposed the postponement of elections in Berhampur, amidst concerns over the safety of festivities and electoral processes. The court emphasized the need for peaceful celebrations and elections. This development underscores the volatile electoral landscape in West Bengal, where polling violence is rampant, prompting extensive deployment of central police forces. Today's next news is: Karnataka High Court recently dismissed challenges to a state government notification banning hookah smoking, asserting that the belief of hookah being less harmful than cigarettes is a misconception. Despite claims, studies reveal hookah's detrimental effects akin to cigarettes. Justice M. Nagaprasanna highlighted the misconception and emphasized the need for stringent regulations, citing WHO findings. This video delves into the court's ruling, exposing the truth behind hookah's risks and the importance of regulatory measures. Today's next news is: in a dramatic turn of events, the Mumbai Police's crime branch makes a significant breakthrough in the investigation of a firing incident outside Salman Khan's residence. During a search operation in the Tapi River, Gujarat, they recovered 2 pistols, 3 magazines, and 13 bullets allegedly used in the shooting, led by Senior Police Inspector Daya Nayak. A dedicated team is tirelessly working on the case with the aid of scuba divers. This revelation adds a new dimension to the ongoing probe, shedding light on the intensity of the incident. Today's next news is: a recent report by Elastic reveals India's global leadership in adopting generative AI technologies. The report, based on insights from 3,200 IT decision makers and influencers, including 300 from India, highlights that 81% of Indian organizations have already incorporated generative AI into their operations. Moreover, a staggering 94% anticipate increased investments and budget allocations towards generative AI initiatives in the next 2 to 3 years. Today's next news is: this year, India is set to witness an unprecedented surge in sugar consumption due to scorching summer temperatures and the mobilization of millions for elections. The heightened demand for cold drinks and ice cream during the peak season from mid-March to mid-June is driving local prices up, benefiting major sugar producers like Balrampur Chini, Sri Renuka Sugars, Bajaj Hindustan, and Dwarikesh Sugar. Avantika Saravgi, executive director at Balrampur Chini Mills, explains how heat waves and election rallies are amplifying the consumption of sugar-based products.
Thanks for tuning in. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more content like this. Your support means the world to us. Stay tuned for our next upload, and until then, keep exploring, learning, and creating.